Jimmy, please say something.
James?
What? Who are you? Mom, I thought you told me never to talk to strangers.
Like I said before, Jimmy, please be nice to your new stepfather.
Okay, rich guy. I love it that you're twice as old as my grandfather and you're fat and bald.
That's enough! I've had it with you, you little brat!
You've upset your mother. I've got half a mind to beat you.
Half a mind is right. Suddenly he realizes.
I can't believe you, you little monster. We'll deal with you when we get back from our honeymoon. Next year.
Here we are, boy, at Bulworth Academy. Have fun, Jimmy. I'll think of you from our cruise ship.
Whatever. Mom, why'd you marry that phony? What is wrong with you? Oh, I can't believe this.
You must be the Hopkins boy.
Where'd you come from?
We've been expecting you. Welcome to Bulworth Academy. Oh, I'm sure you'll be very happy here. Very happy indeed. Anyway, I can't spend my life waiting around for naughty little boys. I've got a man to make happy. The headmaster is expecting you, Hopkins, in his study.
Okay.
His study is over there, boy, in the main building. Don't keep Dr. Crabblesnitch waiting. He's a brilliant man. Brilliant.
Ah, yes. So you must be Hopkins. What? What?
I meant yes, sir.
Very good. Now let me see. You've done a lot of naughty things, haven't you? Vandalism, graffiti, bad language, violent conduct, disrespecting staff. Oh, I'm scared of you, Hopkins.
Come on, give me a break.
Yes, I've never met a boy like you. Never in all my life. Hopkins, you're quite the nastiest little boy I have ever encountered. Tell me, why should I waste my time on you?
I don't know.
Because it's my calling. It's what I do. You excel at causing trouble, and I excel at fixing little boys like you. At making you into respectable members of our community here at the Academy. I've got a good feeling about you, boy. A feeling you and I are going to be great friends. You keep that nose clean, boy. Or I shall clean it myself. Miss Danvers, are you back yet?
Yes, Headmaster. And I got your tea.
You are good to me, Miss Danvers.
No more than you deserve, Headmaster.
Take our new friend Hopkins here and show him around the school and get him properly attired.
Certainly, Headmaster. Come along, boy. I haven't got all day.
And boy, remember, you will have a clean nose. So keep it clean, or we'll clean it for you.
So here I am at probably the worst school in the country,
whose alumni are nothing but arms dealers, serial killers, and corporate lawyers. Real scum. And that old creep thinks he can tame me? We shall see, my friend. I only give people what they have coming to them.
Where's your uniform, young Hopkins? Run along now, child.
I can't tell Mom about that at all. She'd be so mad.
Whatever you say.
What's your problem?
Hey, you're the new kid.
Yeah? What's it to you?
Friendly, aren't you?
Give me a break, loser.
Hey, relax, friend. You're all pent up. Go easy or they put you on medication. They did to me. Boy, nearly sent me insane.
That's fascinating. Now if you'll excuse me.
I said relax, friend.
Get off, man.
Listen to me, tough guy. You just arrived at the toughest school in the country, and I'm offering to be your friend. Trust me, in a place like this, you're gonna need friends. So it's up to you. You gonna play nice or what?
Yeah, sure.
Good. So how about I show you around?
We don't have a bar in the dorm. Just a soda machine.
Let's see you prove how tough you are.
You should probably change into your uniform if you don't want to get in trouble.
Taste the chemical burn.
Hey, how you doing? You must be the new kid. I'm Pete. Pete Kowalski. Jimmy Hopkins, and don't ask how I'm doing. I've been here 5 minutes, and already people want me dead. Even my parents didn't hate me this quickly.
Well, welcome to Bulworth. It's a dump.
Great. I've been expelled from anywhere halfway decent.
Yeah, I've been expelled from anywhere halfway decent, because I'm really bad. Give up the tough guy act, pal.
Hey, man, what's your problem?
Well, ADD primarily, but also life, my parents, this school, Western civilization, but really, honestly, enough about me. Oh. I see you've met the dorm's mascot. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Femboy, the girliest boy in school. Petey, haven't you got some imaginary friends to go annoy?
Why don't you leave me alone, Gary?
Look at you. Leave me alone, Gary. I'm really self-important now that I finally hit puberty. What's your problem? I'm just being nice to the new kid as he passes through Bulworth on his inevitable journey to prison.
Look, I gotta unpack. Would you guys mind getting out of here?
Oh, now look what you've done, Pete. Jimmy can't stand you already.
I'm clearly going.
Russell's locker. You know, the big ape who almost put you in the hospital.
You like to eat fast?
Please don't hurt me.
Your money, all of it!
Aw, oh, please.
Stupid. Kneel before Russell!
Break into it and steal something. That'll teach him. Don't let the prefects see you break any rules. They'll hurt you. Well done.
You do know you're not supposed to be doing that.
Let's have some fun with her.
Go! See what she wants!
Oh, no!
Hey, what's new?
She took my chocolate! Please get it back!
I can sleep.
Watch it!
More important things to worry about!
You're a bad person! It itches.
Why did you do that?
You're gonna fail.
Thanks. Wanna make out? I'll remember this forever.
You actually kissed her. Let's go to the calf. I'll show you who's who. Feeding time at the zoo. Okay, here's the deal. Over there, we got the nerds. Of course, they're complete social outcasts.
They look pretty harmless.
They're actually sneaky bastards. Their turf is the library. And those are the preps. They're all money and condescending attitudes.
Yeah, massively inbred and completely brainless.
Very observant, Jimmy boy. Now, over there are the greasers. They think they're tough.
Or at least try to look tough.
Wouldn't advise messing with them, at least not yet. They hang by the auto shop. And last but not least, the jocks. These guys rule the school. Definitely avoid them.
Whatever, I'm not afraid of some dumb roid monkeys.
You'll learn. Come on, let's go.
You're here to learn, not to goof off. Get to class.
Thank you.
are you doing in here? Oh, right. Class. Take care to follow my instructions precisely, as we will be working with volatile chemicals today. Fascinating, isn't it? Very good. Carry on. Good job. Keep paying attention. Satisfactory work, James. I'll see you next class.
Watch and learn, suckers. I think we can call that a wrap.
If you try anything,
I can't wait to get out of this place.
Check this out, sucker.
You seem to be making yourself quite comfortable here, my boy.
I'm just trying to fit in.
By fighting? By making a nuisance of yourself? That is not the Bulworth way, boy.
Yeah, you could have fooled me.
What?
I said you could have fooled me. This place is full of bullies and maniacs.
Nonsense! That's just school spirit. Hijinks. Why, in my day, we felt nothing of castrating the new boys. I want you to stop this nonsense, Hopkins. I want you to behave yourself. You might learn something.
Fine. Can I go now, sir?
On your way.
Hey, I saw you sucking up to Crabble Snitch.
What? Shut up.
Screw you, new kid. This is what we do to teachers' pets around here.
You better not... Ow! Come here, you little...
Yeah, come and get me.
Nonsense dealt with.
Save it for someone who cares.
All right, man, later. What's the word?
Wait up! I got something.
Dr.
Get into class, you little turd!
Ah, hello, class. The curriculum demands that you do these vocabulary, assignments. Why don't you finish them here in class? That way you'll have more free time. Good show. Good one. Well done. That's right. Keep it up. Good one. 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 Well done, Kings. Well done indeed.
Beg for mercy! I wish someone would cause some trouble.
Come on, give me a break.
Puke brain!
It's easy when you know how. That was easy.
Good for nothing, Paul.
I hope I get it.
I know I'm forgetting to do something.
Watch it!
You know, something's wrong with the freshman start right now.
So that's a good idea, right?
Yeah, okay, all right, sure, I'll do it.
Hey man, what's going on?
Not much.
I was just telling Petey here about my idea to take over the school. I mean, my plan for us to take over the school.
What plan?
Don't worry, Jimmy. It's just a little something I came up with. It's sink or swim, my friend. And if you're good at swimming, you gotta let the losers drown. Why don't you guys leave the thinking up to me?
What?
What? What the? Can't you say anything else? You know what, Petey? You were right. Jimmy is pretty dumb.
What'd you say about me?
Whoa, nothing. No, no, no. All I said was that you had to be pretty dumb to get expelled from so many schools. That's all.
Relax, James. All he said was that you must be dumb. Or maybe you're all messed up because you came from a broken home.
What'd you say about me, dwarf?
Come on, dude. Chill.
No, 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 no. Gary's taking everything out of context, man.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't lie, Petey. Don't you lie. Because you know what happens to liars?
No, no, I'm not lying.
We kick them in the balls! Come on, Jimmy. Let's go see how good you are with this new slingshot I heard you had. Don't worry, friend. Nothing escapes my notice. I hear everything. You and me, we can do things.
Ow. Hey, Hopkins, you psychotic gimp. This way.
Have you ever been to the carnival?
I wonder, did the markers see that?
I want to see your long-range skill. Let's see if you can get up with your slingshot. I guess you don't suck. You do have some talent. Come on, let's go down to the football field.
Go on, Petey. Go cry to the teacher. Tell them I was nasty to you.
Shut up, Gary. You're such a jerk, man.
Oh, am I, Petey? Oh, you're so cutting. I'm really upset. Actually, I think I'm gonna go cry. That'd be just like you. Cry, little girl. Oh, look out. Here comes Jimmy.
Just knock it off, Gary. You're out of line.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize I was hanging out in the girls' dorm.
Silly me.
Shut up, man. You're boring.
Boring? I'm boring. You're none too interesting yourself, friend. Look, I'm sorry, both of you. I apologize, okay? I just get a little overexcited. Forgive me.
Forget it. It's cool.
Anyway, I've got a good idea for some fun. Let's go out and torment someone really helpless and unfortunate. That homeless guy. Come on. You coming, little Petey? Come on, I'm sorry. I'll give you a kiss if that's what you want.
Shut up.
Then come on.
This is how the educate
people. This is gonna be fun.
Harassing some old homeless guy is fun?
It is.
No,
and
you
should be grateful you're not the victim for once.
I guess.
Hey, Jimmy, tell me about this guy. Does he like to go in his own pants?
Where is this dirty old perv?
You know, you're not very nice, Gary.
And you're a loser, Petey. One of life's unfortunates.
Get out of here, you little scum!
So I guess the rumors are true, Jimmy. Your dad does live on campus.
You jerk!
Ow! Let's leave this guy to his welfare payments. Come on, let's get out of here.
Just get out of here, kid.
Why should I?
Because otherwise I'll kill you.
What's your problem?
That's a long story. You got any liquor?
No, I'm 15.
Well, what about drugs?
No.
Then why shouldn't I kill you?
All right then, tough guy, kill me.
You know what, kid? I like your style. You got guts. When I was on that ridge in Korea, watching my buddies get killed by friendly fire, I could have used somebody like you.
Yeah? Thanks.
But I bet you can't fight. You do me a favor, and I'll show you some real moves. Classified moves. Real Special Army stuff.
Cool.
Just get me a part for my radio, and I'll show you what the Army taught me.
What, like how to get shot by your own side?
Exactly.
Transistor when you come back.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Miss Phillips, and it is my pleasure to induct you into the world of arts. Certainly captured my character. Very well.
Hey, wanna hang out?
Hi there. I really love bunnies. They're so nice.
I got this for you.
Oh, Jimmy, that's so nice of you.
You're even better up close.
You're so bad.
That's how you do it. I'm done.
I heard a fraternity is a good place to make friends.
I think Oscar Wilde...
Well, stick it in your ear!
Look at the moron, ha!
Why'd Mr. Galloway tell me I wasn't so?
I'm going to report you!
Oh, so, you're the new kid, huh? Everyone is talking about you.
Oh, are they? And what are they saying?
Nothing. Just that you're friends with that sociopath Gary.
Socio what?
Sociopath. It means... Never mind. Forget I said anything. I need you to help me.
Wait, you need me to help you?
I've got some library books that need to be returned, but I'm too scared to go to my locker.
Do I look like a librarian?
No, listen. I need your help. Pretend we're friends. Walk with me. I'll pay you $2.
$2? Are you crazy? Make it $5.
No. $2?
Great. $5. Let's go, buddy.
My mom calls me. Wanna be friends?
Hey, Algebra!
Oh, just you wait! I'll teach you what it means to be hard.
I can skip this year.
Cover me! I'm going in! Hey! Were there two people
here? Hey! Trench said they went into the bathroom.
I always knew I could do it.
For some wrestling instruction. This will require physical contact between you and your opponent. Don't any of you enjoy it?
Hey, all you polar men, stand up and clap.
Another crushing blow for Fatty. My esteem fall
right,
any lower? Please, I have nervous back. I'm gonna die of embarrassment.
That's right, Hopkins, get close and personal.
So many years ahead of me! Don't do it! My tender soul, crushed!
That's what I'd like to see!
You don't want to touch me!
Hopkins,
that was
contagious!
I can't do anything right! I shall maim thee!
All right, boys! I want to see you sweat! I was wrong about you. Maybe you really are a really strong girl.
That's how it's done.
Run where Kirby looked at you.
Give it back!
Or what?
Or, well, just give it back!
Are you threatening me, Metal Mouth?
No, I just give it back! You can't just steal things from me!
Unfortunately for you, my pig ugly friend, that is exactly what I can do. In fact, I can do anything I like in this place. Anything at all. Ciao, Spotty.
Give it back!
And you should stay out of the girls' dorm, you little perv. I see you undressing me with your eyes. Sicko.
You wish.
Please, will you help me?
Do I have to?
Yes, it's vital. She's stolen my lab notes. Without them, I'm gonna fail chemistry and I'll never get into med school. Now I won't find the cure for cancer. Basically, the future of the whole world rests on those notes.
What's in it for me?
Well, if you get them back, I'll kiss you.
Ugh, that's okay.
Well, okay, but... if you don't, I'll tell the whole school you're some kind of sad sicko who spies on girls getting changed in their dorm.
Relax. One set of lab notes coming up.
So, I'm gonna need your help with this. Yeah, I'm game. Thanks.
Sorry. Sorry about that.
Cut it out! Stop, Gary. Trying to watch this.
Ah, swim team. Intellectual stuff. So, tell me, Petey, do you like watching the girls in their swimming costumes? Does that fuel your filthy little fantasies?
Gary, just get out of the way.
Oh, Marion, show me your breaststroke again. Or, wait, do you like the boys on the team?
Yeah, right, Gary.
Which is it, Petey?
I see you guys are getting along as usual.
I'm just toughening him up.
Ow.
Turning him into a man or a woman or something.
Hey, Jimmy. Hey, Petey.
Ah, peace stain. Good to see you.
Listen, Jimmy, I need a favor. Bucky went to the auto shop to get some parts for his science projects. He hasn't come back yet. I think he might be in trouble. Please?
Why don't you go yourself?
I've got homework. Okay, I'm frightened. And I've got a weak bladder. Oh, I think the bullies might have gotten him. Please, I'll pay.
I say do it. It's a good chance to show Russell who's in charge around here. Now run along, Peace Stain, before you mark the carpet. Yes. We've got to take care of Russell and his boys. Then, after that, take care of all the other cliques. Soon, this school will be ours.
I don't want the school.
Yeah, well, I do, pal, and I intend to get it. Now go help that dork.
And what are you gonna do?
I've got planning to do.
Knock it off.
Sorry.
Boop. Stop.
Sorry.
There's a violent, crazy old man on campus.
Thanks, Timmy. That's right. Here, take this.
Jimmy Hopkins delivers.
Can you help me, please?
Hey, Jimmy.
I need to get back to the girls' dorm. Will you please walk me home?
Oh, it's okay. I'll
break every bone in your scrawny little body.
And give up being a prefect.
School elections are always rigged with money changing hands. I'm so bored. I wish something would happen. It was nice of you.
You cool?
Hi, it's me.